Hello, darlings. Welcome to Baking Live. I am so excited to show you what I have been dreaming up the last few days. I have an amazing trip to Alaska coming up. So I have been thinking about Baked Alaska all of a sudden, which is hilarious, but a different twist on Baked Alaska. For those of you who've never tried it or ever seen a Baked Alaska, it's very impressive. It actually takes a lot of time, but the version I'm going to show you is actually a cheating way, but also it will impress anyone you put in front of. So let's get started. You guys are going to love this, and let's make Baked Alaska. First step is getting brownie bites together. You can make these homemade, or they actually sell these in most grocery stores. These are just mini little brownie bites, delicious, and we are gonna top these with some ice cream. Next step is we actually just put our little brownie bites in a pan, and I'm going to add my favorite gelato on top. You can add your favorite ice cream. So I've got a mini ice cream scoop, and I'm literally going to add softened ice cream on top of each brownie bite, just like this. We have our ice cream dollops on top of our brownie bites. This happens to be a mint chocolate gelato. It's Mediterranean mint. I have a feeling it's gonna taste absolutely divine on top of a brownie. So we're gonna freeze this until the ice cream is nice and hard. All right, guys, scene change here. In a saucepan, we have 4 egg whites at room temperature, 1/2 cup of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of cream of tartar, and a little pinch of salt. I'm gonna place this over another saucepan full of hot water. Now you wanna be careful not to dip this pan into the hot water because our eggs will cook. But we're gonna cook our egg white mixture. I'm gonna whisk pretty fast. For about 4 minutes until all the sugar is dissolved in your mixture. As it's cooking, it's going to look very foamy. And remember, don't stick the pan too far into the hot water, otherwise your eggs will cook. Back at our original workstation, I have just finished cooking my egg whites over a Bain-Marie. And we are going to put this in a KitchenAid mixer. If you don't have one, you can use a hand mixer as well. And we're gonna beat this for about 6 minutes until you have nice stiff peaks. And I'm gonna add a little bit of vanilla extract in as well. And this is gonna go on top of our beautiful Baked Alaska. It's gonna look gorgeous. Here we go. These beautiful stiff peaks. Our beautiful meringue is finished. It's gonna go on top of our Baked Alaska. I have a piping bag with a star-shaped tip. You don't have to have a star-shaped tip, but it makes for a very pretty design on Baked Alaska. So this is really dense. By adding the cream of tartar, it makes the meringue incredibly sturdy. So brownie bites are perfect. The ice cream is hard now, and I'm going to pipe some beautiful meringue all around my beautiful brownie bite. And I'm gonna kind of like go crazy with it because it's gonna be fun. I can't wait to show you guys this when I'm done. Okay, this is so cute. It's like my own little igloo. It's adorable. This is my favorite part of this whole procedure. Every girl should own a blowtorch, and here's why. So we are going to just blowtorch around our meringue, and if you've ever seen Baked Alaska, it's nice and toasty on the outside, so here we go. And I'll try not to burn it. To cut into this, and I just love that it's mini. It's so cute. We're gonna see how cute the inside is. Look at this, guys. This is so sweet. All right, mini Baked Alaskas. All right, this is gonna be messy.